So we're starting the session. It's 11:30 sharp at this moment in the Netherlands. It is. Welcome to this webinar. My name is Jurgen van Gils. I'm from Vision BI, and this is already the fourth webinar in a series of webinars that we run on Yellowfin 9. That means that there are three other webinars already given. If you want access to those webinars, please send me a message and I'll make sure that you will get the links to the webinars so you can view them afterwards. And also this webinar you can view afterwards. I will make sure you all get a link to it. Yellowfin 9 is released since the beginning of this year, and it brings the next level of business intelligence and analytics. I've told that a few times in the last sessions already. And we have shown some of these cool features. And these cool features are beautiful dashboards that you can build with the Canvas mode, data storytelling, that was the previous session that we did, ETL functionality that's included in Yellowfin, and also a code mode is included. It's a no-code, low-code option to add customizations and interactions to your dashboards. There are out-of-the-box interactions included that don't need any coding, but you can also code them yourselves. I warn you, some of these might look complex, especially if you don't code, but we see there is a certain structure in there. So if you have done it once, you can reuse the code and adjust it and easily use it again. So, and we are there to help you, of course, and we would love to share the code, also the code that we show in this webinar with you. Gabi is going to show some of these cool examples, and we really hope you to understand where code mode could help you to take action on your dashboard. So how to incorporate it in your business processes and let it help you in your day-to-day decisions and take action on those decisions. If you see opportunities or have ideas, please share them with us. There's a Q&A window on the site of the webinar, so you can ask questions where this could be of interest for you, or other examples maybe, but you can also drop an email to us and suggest your ideas, of course. There's also a Yellowfin BI user group on LinkedIn. It would be nice if we could share thoughts and ideas and also codes over there, of course. In exactly 2 weeks, we have a webinar on Signals, a real-time monitoring solution based on machine learning algorithms, and that tells you what is going on in your data. It's a great solution of Yellowfin, also a great solution, that makes analyzing and monitoring your data even easier. So the invite for this webinar is published on the Vision BI website and also on the LinkedIn user group, the Yellowfin BI user group. So you can get a link for it. I now hand over to Gary Hurst. He's a senior Yellowfin consultant working for Vision BI. And I hope you're all gonna enjoy this session. I now move it to you.
Okay, hello everyone, I'm Gary Hurst. I'm a Yellowfin consultant, as Jurgen mentioned. And today we're going to talk about the code mode in Yellowfin. Now, code mode was introduced in version 9, along with the new dashboard freeform canvas. And as Jurgen mentioned, we've looked at this in previous webinars, how do we create our dashboards and presentations. But today is all about the background, the back end. What happens in the back end, and how can I extend the functionality of my dashboards and presentations? Now, for those of you that are not that technical, don't worry. This is a technical session, but not too technical. And all of the examples we will show you today is fairly generic, so you should be able to use it as is in your environment. But what we really hope to achieve is to get you thinking about what can you do with your dashboards in order to make it more actionable and user-friendly for your users. Now, code mode, what is it? It's basically an editor, a code editor, that will allow you to make changes to your components on your dashboard canvas. You can even create your own user interface objects and functionality from scratch. So it's really giving you all of the flexibility and all of the power to do what you want to do in your dashboards. Developers don't need to go and learn new proprietary database languages. Yellowfin makes use of familiar languages like HTML, JavaScript, and Stylesheet. But you do need some background and coding skills if you want to make this work on your dashboards. Yellowfin also introduced the contextual and state-aware KPI. Now, this will enable you to access each of the objects or components on your dashboard and its properties. You can even access the dashboard itself and change the properties of that specific dashboard. Now, CodeMode was designed with the technical users in mind. But what about the business users? How do they, that are not that technical, make use of these fancy features in Yellowfin? And Yellowfin created an extensible widget framework specifically for this. So this is where the developers can go and create code snippets or code widgets that the other users in the organization can just use. So other users can just drag and drop a code widget onto their canvas and then using low code or no code, make use of these features. Yellowfin ships with three code widgets out of the box. There's a signal list. Now signals, as Jurgen mentioned, this is where Yellowfin will automatically monitor your data in the backend. Now you can bring those insights directly to your dashboard using the signal widget. It's also context sensitive. So in other words, you can configure it to only show you the signals that's relevant to the dashboard that you're looking at. There's also a custom HTML widget where we can add any custom HTML code and it will show up on our dashboard. This is also what we can use for embedding third-party content onto your Yellowfin dashboard. And then lastly, Yellowfin also have an associated reports widget. Now this widget, you can drag onto your dashboard to show the users a list of related or associated reports. So you're not visualizing the report on the dashboard, but there's almost like a shortcut link to go to the specific reports. As you know by now, Yellowfin also have action buttons. We've looked in previous webinars at the events that Yellowfin ships with. For example, I can create a new or open up a new web page or a specific report, and you can even reset the filter values or a dashboard using those action buttons and events that Yellowfin ships with. Today, we're going to look at extending the functionality of those action buttons using CodeMode. So you can now go and create your custom workflows. You can trigger internal or external events, and you can even push and pull data from third-party applications. To give you an example, is we can look at the performance data by product on our Yellowfin dashboard. And then if you see a problem with one product, you can just click on it and it will automatically create a new marketing campaign in your CRM system. So all of that is done from one application or tool on your Yellowfin dashboard. So it really allows you to create that action-driven dashboard. So let's go into an example. So in previous webinars, we've created this sales performance dashboard. So what we're going to do today is change the behavior and the look and feel of this dashboard using CodeMode. Now, the first thing that I want to show you is how do we access CodeMode? And if I edit this dashboard, you'll notice here at the top, I have this toggle button to switch between visual and CodeMode. Now, if you don't see this, it only means that your role permissions do not allow you to add custom code to your dashboard. So all you need to do, talk to your database administrator or system administrator and have them enable code mode for your specific user. Then we can switch between code mode and visual mode. In code mode, you'll notice that we have an editor here. This is our HTML editor, where we have all of our HTML code. There's a JavaScript editor, where we can add our custom JavaScript code in there. And then lastly, a style sheet editor, where we can change the look and feel of the objects on our dashboard. If we go back to the HTML editor, you'll notice here on the left, we have a list of all of the objects that we currently have on our dashboard. And as I hover over each of these, Yellowfin will highlight the code in the code editor to give me an idea of where that code is located. Any changes that I make here, so if we look at this title, there's the sales performance title. Now if I make a change here, let's call this sales update, and I now go to visual mode, the change is immediately reflected on that side. And similarly, if I change this back to performance, and I go to code mode, again, the change is updated on this side. So Yellowfin will auto-save any changes in this editor, and it will even show you any mistakes that you've made. So there's alerts for errors as well. Now, the next thing that I would like to do is on our filter box that we have here, there's our filter box that we've added. There's a filter title called demographic with a list of available options. Now, if I want to hide this filter title, the demographic text, there's no way of doing that using standard Yellowfin functionality. So for this, I'm going to use the style sheet functionality. So to do that, again, I go to code mode, I go to my style sheets, and then in here, I basically just copy this in here. There we go. We add our code in there to hide the filter title. Now, how do we do that? We access the filter title there using standard CSS formatting, and we set the display property to none. So in other words, we hide that value from the user. So if I now go to preview, you'll notice that the demographic is not showing anymore. So that's how I hide it using basic CSS coding. Okay. Next, what I want to do is add a tooltip on this dashboard, so next to this report. So if a user hovers over an image on the screen, I want to show a tooltip explaining the report in detail. When a user navigates away from that image, I want to hide the tooltip. Okay, so again, how do we do that? So we go back to our edit mode, and then for the information button, I'm going to add this image next to the title there. This is a little bit too big, so let's make it smaller. And in order to access this image using code mode, I'm going to give this a name. So I'm going to call this my info image or info button in this case. Next, we want to add a tooltip. So for this, we're going to utilize Yellowfin's text widget. So this is just a standard text widget that we drag in here. Make it a little bit smaller. And then we're going to enter our text in there. So there's the text for our tooltip. Now, currently the background for this tooltip is transparent, so it doesn't really look like a tooltip. So we're going to use the text properties box in order to change the properties. So we're going to background formatting and set the background to an actual color, so it's not transparent anymore. And we can also change some of the other settings here using this properties panel. For example, we can add padding around the text, and we can even add a shadow. Let's do that. So now it looks a little bit more like a tooltip. The problem is, if I now preview my dashboard, this tooltip is always showing because it's just a text object on our canvas. So we would now like to go and hide that that tooltip from the user when they first open the dashboard. So again, we go to our code mode, go to style sheets, and then in here, we add the text or the code to hide the tooltip. Now we do the same thing that we've done with the filter title. We access the tooltip using its name, and we set the display property to none. Okay. Now, currently, let me just, before we preview this, sorry, let's go there. Just want to give this tooltip a name. Currently, it's called paragraph text. So again, this will be tooltip. Now we can access it using code mode. The next thing we want to do is, if I hover over this icon, I want to change the cursor of the mouse to a pointer. So again, in the code mode, style sheets, we're going to access the info button, and we add a hover event almost in there. So then we change the cursor to a pointer. So now if I go to preview, you don't see the tooltip anymore. And if I hover over there, you can see the mouse cursor is changing to a pointer. Okay, so the last step in making this tooltip work is to actually go and show the tooltip when I hover over that icon, and when I move away, hide the tooltip. So for this, we will need to add some JavaScript code. So we go to code mode, JavaScript, And then in our JavaScript editor, we just add our code in there. So again, here, what we do is we access the info button or image that we have, and then we add a function or hover. So that will access our tooltip and it will show that. If I move away from that info button, we're going to hide the tooltip from the users. Okay, so this is standard simple JavaScript code in order to do this. If we now preview this, you don't see the tooltip, and when I hover over there, the tooltip will show, and if I move away, it will automatically be hidden from the users. So that's how I add and show tooltips on my screen. Okay, next, I'm going to create a new dashboard. Let's call this my dashboard. I'm going to use the freeform canvas. And for this one, we're going to use our code widgets. Now, here's the three standard widgets that Yellowfin ships with. I can now go and add any one of them to the dashboard. So in this case, I just drag it and drop it onto the canvas. You can resize it. But basically, all this is a placeholder for HTML code. Okay, this one is called custom HTML. If I now go to code mode, there you can see there's our object, our custom object, and anything that I type in here will show up on my dashboard. So if I now go to preview, you'll see the text hello world in there. So this is really a basic, simple example. What we can also do is, using this code widget, is embed third-party content. So for today, if we look at our presentation slides, I can now go, I can go to my file options. This is in SharePoint, a PowerPoint presentation. I can go and share this. I'm going to the embed link. I can then just copy this iframe code that PowerPoint will give me. Okay, so I'm not doing any coding. I'm just copying the code. Then from here, we go back to Yellowfin, and we paste that code in there. So that's the code that we've copied from PowerPoint. So if I now go and preview, this should give me my PowerPoint presentation on my dashboard. So this is how you embed third-party content directly onto your Yellowfin dashboard. Okay, the next example is where we have a standard Yellowfin report. So this is to update our athlete details. It will show us all of our athletes with the camp rating. Then we have an HTML form where we created this form with labels and input boxes. And we have a submit button here at the bottom. So what will happen is, if I select any of the rows in here, Yellowfin will automatically extract the value that I've selected, the row that I've selected, and populate these values in this HTML form. And I do this using the APIs that Yellowfin ships with. Okay, so I access the record that I click on, and I populate this form. Then when I click on the submit button, we will take everything that's in this form, and we will store it in a database. So we're actually going to update the data in our database directly from a Yellowfin dashboard. And then lastly, we'll trigger a refresh action to read the data again from the database and show us the new data in our report. So if I click on this Julian and I change his first name and I click on submit, Yellowfin is now writing the data back to the database and refreshing the report. So this is how you can change data directly from your Yellowfin dashboard. So how did we do this? Again, we go to the edit button, edit this dashboard. Here we have our standard Yellowfin report. This report is called Athlete Details. Here we have our HTML form where we created all of these fields with their labels. Now you'll notice it looks a little bit different, the actual fields, than what we see on the screen. So if I go to preview, this looks like nice big input values. And we change the behavior using the style sheets. Okay, so you can add your own style sheets in here. Then in the JavaScript code editor, we set a variable called dashboard to the actual dashboard. And we use this object that Yellowfin gives us with the API's parameter to access that dashboard. We also set the report variable to the actual report, the athlete details report that we get from standard Yellowfin functionality. So this is this.apis.canvas.select, and we select that object. Then, by default, Yellowfin will give us two functions in the JavaScript editor, onRender and onRemove. Now, the onRender function is where you can add any code that you want to execute when a user opens this dashboard tab. So this is a good place for your event listeners and stuff like that. The onRemove function is will be executed every time a user navigates away from the dashboard. So this is where you do your cleanup. Now, in this onRender function, we use our report variable that we set here at the top, and we add a click event listener. Okay, so on click of that report, when a user clicks on that report, we set these variables to the objects, the input boxes on in our HTML form. Okay, and we again use the API to select them. So there's the athlete ID and the first name. Then we access the row that the user clicked on, and then we populate the values of those input boxes using the columns from the Yellowfin report. So that's the first step. We click on a report and we populate the form. Next, when a user click on a submit button, so there's our click event, click function on the submit button. We set these variables again to the objects on the screen, the input boxes, the value of those boxes. So that's how I get my athlete ID and first name. And we then build up this URL string. So we are going to call this update athlete details.jsp page. And we're going to pass the athlete ID and the first name as a parameter. And then we execute that JSP page and we do the refresh in order to show the new data and the report from our database. Now, the reason we're calling a JSP page, JavaScript code is executing on the client side in the browser. And the JSP page, Java server page, is executing on the backend on the server side. So any sensitive information that you don't want to show to the public, you would store in your JSP page. Now the JSP page is where we will actually do the work. So if I open that JSP page and show you this, this is the athletedetails.jsp page. Here, what we do is we set a variable to the input parameter that was passed to this JSP page. So in this case, the athlete ID and the first name. Then we set a source ID for our data source to the Yellowfin data source ID. And the reason we do this is we're going to utilize Yellowfin's database administration and data source administration. So we don't want to pass our own user credentials and connection details for our databases. We're going to make use of Yellowfin's data sources. And each data source in Yellowfin have a unique data source ID. Okay, that ID you can access from the repository database using the report view source table. Okay, so basically we create a new action, database action, using that source ID. Then we create a statement, SQL statement, that we're going to execute. So this is where we update the athlete details. We set the first name to the parameter that was passed, and we use the athlete ID parameter to uniquely identify that record. Then we do the update on the database and we commit that changes. So that's how easy it is to change data on our dashboard. So if we now publish this again, every time I click on a record, remember we use the API to access the record that we've clicked on, we populate the values, we change the values in here on the HTML form, when we click on submit, we're committing the data in the database and then refresh the report on the screen. Okay. The next example is where we have the users using an Excel document to maintain their budgets. So this is a standard Excel document with a list of products and then the values for each month. So that's the budget value for each month. Now in Yellowfin, what we normally would do is we would ask the user to go and store or save or export that Excel document as a CSV document, a comma separated file. And then they have to manually import that or use the transformation flow tool or the ETL tool to import the data, store it in the database, and then we can write the report from there. With this code mode example, we now give the user the ability to maintain an Excel document. First of all, they don't need to go to CSV anymore, import that, and then visualize the results directly on the screen, on the dashboard. So what we do here is we have our file selector, so we just browse for a file. We select that file that we've just looked at, And now we upload the data, store it in the database, and visualize it on the Yellowfin dashboard. Okay, so how did we do this? We go to edit, go to code mode. Before we do that, here's our standard report. This is called budget report. And here we have our upload form, which is the HTML code widget. We go to code mode, we go to the upload form. This is where we ask the user for a file. So this is where they can browse for the file. And using JavaScript, we set our budget report variable, again, using the API to access that report, the budget report. This is just the URL of the JSP page we're going to call. And then on render, remember, every time I open a dashboard, this function will execute. We basically allow the user to enter the value or monitor at the listener. So when they enter the value, we're going to execute this code. We get the file name that was selected, and we run this upload budget function. Now, if we go to the upload budget function, what we do here is we create a new XML HTTP request. We basically append the file that was selected to that request, and we execute that, the JSP page on the server side. Okay, and then when we get the data back, we basically just trigger a refresh of all of our reports. If we go to the JSP page, again, the same concept that we've done before with the other example, we make use of Yellowfin's data sources. So there we create our new database action. Then we upload the data. And I'm not going to go into too much detail here. As I've mentioned, these examples will be made available on request. But basically, we upload the data from the Excel document into memory. And from there, we build our insert statement. So this is insert into standard SQL all of the values that we want to update, the column names. And then here, we loop through each of the rows in the Excel document. We update the values and add that to our insert statement. And before we execute it, we delete everything from the table. So this is just the delete statement. We run the prepare of that. Then we do the update. And lastly, we do the same thing here for our insert statement. So now, and I change, let's say, Sportsmaster 2000 to 60. I save the Excel document. Go back to Yellowfin. Browse for our file. Yellowfin will update the value and store it in a database, visualize that on the screen. Lastly, our last example I want to show you today is here what we've done is we've integrated Yellowfin with a help desk system called Freshdesk. So we've just added the help desk widget onto our dashboard. So what we do here is we access the Yellowfin username and email address that's currently logged into Yellowfin. And now the users can directly type in here. So I need help, please. We can even take screenshots. So all of this is available using the Freshdesk help desk widget. And when this is loaded, we can then go and create a ticket. So now this ticket is automatically created in the Freshdesk help desk application. And we didn't even have to leave Yellowfin for that. And just to show you, just go there. So there we have our Freshdesk help desk system. If I go to tickets, there's the new ticket that was just created with our screenshot in there. So all of this was done directly from Yellowfin. And again, users don't have to leave the application in order to go and add a ticket in there. Okay, so what are the next steps? So now that you've seen what you can do with code mode, how do you make use of this? The first thing, you need to upgrade to Yellowfin version 9. Code mode is only available in version 9 of Yellowfin. Then if you want more information, you can go to the wiki pages. It's wiki.yellowfinbi.com. There's a lot of information. There's even examples on how to implement code mode in your environment. We can also recommend that you go and read up on the subject, on the especially the programming languages like HTML, JavaScript, and style sheets. Here's a book that we can definitely recommend. It covers all three of those in one document or one book. So go and read this book if it's possible. As I've mentioned earlier, we will also make all of these examples available to you. Just send us an email and we'll send you the examples. We can also share it with you on LinkedIn. We have a Yellowfin BI user group, and please go and share your examples with us as well so that we all can learn. So make use of that. Then with that, I really hope that we've given you a glimpse of what is possible using Code Mode. So the purpose of the day was not to teach you how to code, it's just to show you and make you think of what you can actually do with Yellowfin, so that you can go and create your own actionable dashboards that will improve the experience that the users have. Okay, so with that, if there's any questions, we'll see if we can answer them. Otherwise, we'll get back to you afterwards. Jurgen, any questions?
Yes, Gabi, there were quite some questions during the sessions. I had the liberty to to answer them already, but I don't know if everybody can see the questions that have been asked, so I will refer to a few of them. The last one is, could you also integrate Microsoft Teams inside of Yellowfin? And I know that we looked at it, and Teams is not yet available as a separate iframe like Freshdesk is, that you saw in the example, but you can call Teams actually with API. So if you have a message that you enter in Yellowfin, you would be able to send it to Teams, to a group, for instance, or a channel to publish that. That's all possible with Code Mode. That's what I have to say about it. I don't know if you can add something.
No, Jurgen, I agree with you. That would be the only way to, at the moment, to integrate with Teams is using the API.
Yeah. This one is obviously based on security for security reasons. Must the data source be writable in order to use JSP file to update records?
Yes, if you want to make changes to the database, it needs to be writable, firstly on the database level, and then secondly, because we're making use of Yellowfin's database module or data source module, the database must be flagged as a writable database. So then you should be able to write to that database. And what we normally do is we don't want the users to actually write to our transactional database, so it's best practice to create a separate database and then allow them to write to that database. Because with Code Mode, they can actually override the data in your database. So that's why it's also not available to all of the users. You have to go and specifically give users access to Code Mode. But once the dashboard is developed, you can deploy that to everybody. They can't do damage because they can't change the code in the backend.
Okay, and I see an interesting question. I saw the PowerPoint integration. Could you also do that with Excel and have your budget entered in Excel in a dashboard? We talked about that, guys.
Yes, I've actually done that. I've integrated Excel into a Yellowfin dashboard, and you can enter the values in there. At the moment, I must say that I'm having issues on the Excel side if you make changes to save those changes in Excel. So that's still something that I need to get by, but yes, you can definitely integrate Excel on the dashboard.
Okay, I see somebody with his email address that asked, could you send the code snippets to me with his webinar, but with his email address, I will not publish it, but yes, we can send it over. That's no problem, of course. And there's a question, can the user language, for instance, region, be retrieved in Code Mode, not meant the local browser settings? I answered that question before, and I said, indeed, with JavaScript, you can also read preferences from your browser, which browser do you use, what's the size of the screen, etc. But this question refers more to how to get the region you're in with Code Mode.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so basically, let me just show you here. If we go edit this, you can definitely access those details using the JSP pages. So we had an issue with this Freshdesk integration to access the email address of the user. And in order to do that, we had to do it in the JSP page, to get the user's information in there. But let me just add. So let me just get there, I'll show you now. So in order to access the user's email address that's logged into Yellowfin, we had to use the session attributes from Yellowfin in order to do that. So that's the only reason we call this JSP, to get the user's email address and then populate the widget on the Yellowfin dashboard in order to integrate with Freshdesk. So I haven't accessed the language, but you should be able to do it using the exact same method. Okay.
Okay, I have another question. Could you log in to embedded frames using single sign-on from Yellowfin, the pass-through security functionality?
I don't know, you should be able to do that. With Yellowfin, you can definitely use single sign-on to log into Yellowfin. So theoretically, if using coding, you should be able to do that. But yeah, that is something that we'll need to test.
It probably also depends on the application that you try to connect. If it's open,
yes,
to get the SSO credentials.
Open. Correct, yeah. Yes, definitely.
But normally, for instance, we have integrated Yellowfin and Azure Active Directory with the multi-factor authentication. So if you're authenticated via that system, automatically all the applications that are included in Yellowfin and that also uses multi-factor authentication from Microsoft is granted access.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. I see these were the questions. I will publish the questions also so everybody can see. Yeah, this is it. And we are a little bit over time. But we had a huge audience, I see. So it's a successful webinar, and I hope everybody has enjoyed it and is really starting to tingle its mind. How can we use it and integrate it into our business processes? So we have dashboards that really, where you can really take action on, and that's where Code Mode is definitely helpful. So thank you all for attending this webinar, and I hope to see you in 2 weeks when the Signals webinar is gonna be held. Okay.
Yeah, from my side, thank you everyone, and see you in 2 weeks. Bye.
Okay. Bye.